Welcome back to the Magic Circle. Let's keep moving.
Right now, you got outside eyes. Nothing here seems real. That's good. See, the gods of this place mean to kill that disbelief. I aim to keep it alive. Mouth to filthy mouth.
Ladies, this is not the demo area.
The intern is, practicing. I was reminding her that any color scheme must be approved by you.
Coda can use any color she wants. In fact, Coda, come with me. Bring your opinions.
I'm honored, my lord.
Okay, I like that, but maybe don't ever do it.
Now, you might wonder why you're doing all the dirty jobs. Part of the reason is I'm in a jail of sorts and had to learn to work this world in less direct ways. But mainly it's 'cause I'm lazy. Feels good, you know, admitting it.
It looks like we're no longer in the demo part of the game. We're now in some unfinished sandbox, who knows, part of the world. One thing I really liked about the game that I hinted at, and I'm not going to explicitly state, is that when they recorded the sound for the game, when they recorded the music, they paused.
This next time just a little quieter, sorry.
And sometimes just cut off the music to record notes from the conductor. Pretty cool.
I guess you were supposed to live out a fairy tale, born to end some war when your sword got big enough. But the gods would have had to agree on all your powers, so you get none. But look around. Every creature here was abandoned by the gods. Let them be your fists, your fangs.
That's what I get for goofing around while the old pro's talking to me, isn't it? So it looks like we've stumbled into the forest of half-baked ideas. Unfortunately, Clyde isn't going to be much help in a fight, but we do have fangs in the form of a mushroom. And of course, we can always just trap enemies and hop inside them.
Guard dog, huh? Smart. But if he lifts a leg on you, I may get my first laugh in years.
So now we have a second ally in the form of a howler. He's probably going to remain nameless. I'm going to be cycling through these allies fairly regularly, so no real reason to give him a name. The Howler appears to be able to hold his own in the fight, although he can take some damage, so I can go ahead and heal him up. A common occurrence is going to be me hopping into these enemies that we've defeated and stripping them of all their powers, just so I can use, say, their movement or their attack if I want it later.
Okay, boss, now, I had something important for this area. Forgot what I was gonna say.
Fair enough. I'll take the increase to life, though. Of course, anytime you want to refill an enemy like I did to that guy whose powers I stripped, you use up a little bit of your own life, so if I would have gotten hit at any point here, I would be instantly dead. Unfortunately, that means I couldn't hop in that mushroom, which contains a little bit of audio, so we'll have to turn around and go get that after we head through to the end of the forest here.
Ooh, yeah. That stupid cinematic is glitched again. You're stuck behind widescreen bars until you hard quit. Tell you what, though. As a gesture of good faith, I'll just break you out of story jail. There. Now imagine being stuck in that cutscene for 10 actual years. That's my life here. When my gameplay's too rough for his story bible, Ish tears the controls right out of my hands. But I think you can help me get fired. I'm guessing you hacked in. Good. This game is broken, right? So exploit it. Abuse it. Make it chase you on a leash. I'll be watching.
Even though the old pro is hardly a fan of the game gods, it looks like Maze's and the old pro's interests are starting to align a little bit. As for me, I got my life, so I'm gonna head back to this mushroom.
Maze, can we talk about the motion cameras? These headsets. Given what I'm, what you're asking me to accomplish, it's risky to speak freely into so many mics.
Yeah, you learn to unsee them. The whole office is wired up. Everything you do or say here is considered content that we own, in case it's genius.
It is. So, that's why you have to get fired. Contractually, the company cedes control of your likeness, your voice.
But if I just quit before we ship, haha, they keep the rights. Anyway, don't sweat the mics. At TMC, assume the spectrum runs from total indifference to total incompetence. Nobody actually checks the recordings. And my plan gets me fired before they come into play.
It looks like our characters are starting to fall into place. At the top, we have Ishmael Gilder. Long gone are his days of the old text adventure that made him famous, the original Magic Circle.
Here we go. Bigger.
He's been spending the last couple decades obsessing over this new follow-up, hoping maybe to capture some of the magic of the original game. And of course we have Coda, the fanatic fangirl. Ish really seems to have taken a liking to her sycophantic praise, and it looks like her eyes are about as big as his in the flowery story world-building perspective. And of course we have Maze Evelyn. What drew her from the life of game, pro gaming, to the game development world? Have the years spent trying to add gameplay to Ish's story-crafting universe really caused her to become this jaded?
Maze, can you watch over my shoulder as I set up my first creature? I want this howler to track the Juggo by scent, flank it, and then pounce.
Just set the howler to hate the hero.
No! I mean, some of them should if they get hungry, but global kill on sight lacks a certain ecological truth.
Trust me. You set two creatures to fight, it's just Muppet sex, man. All impact, no joy. Looks terrible. But if the hero gets attacked directly, they've got no time to see the stupid.
What about downtime? Can I at least make them sleep? Or pee?
Just make them patrol in a loop. You want truth, Grasshopper? Watch what Ish actually does between meetings. You walk in a big enough circle, everyone you meet thinks you've got somewhere to be.
It looks like Coda's finally getting her taste of the real world, so to speak. As much as we would love our games to be perfect, lifelike simulations of what we think a reality might be, sometimes it's just really not feasible. It does sound like Maze has had this conversation before. Spoilers.
So, the fort in the forest. The hero has managed to elude the savage howler pack, right?
Minus any weapons.
But here he learns that they are an intelligent race, caged for generations by the villagers. The predatory behavior now is a rebellion. Sort of my Animal Farm take on the slave trade.
Oh man, if I tell you how dumb you sound, will you be too embarrassed to fire me?
Maze, please.
Look at the actual human population of your fantasy world. Want Coda to do a little diversity census on the whiteboard? Or, you know, just leave it blank?
Oh. Coda, please tell the art guys that we need to talk about the townsfolk. Until then, let's revert to placeholder skins, please.
And there we have our explanation for the default placeholder textures on the villagers back in the demo area. Let's grab Clyde and head down into the cave. It appears that we've reached a dead end. So we're gonna toss Clyde into the void and follow him in. Unfortunately, it looks like we've left our allies back up on the surface, but any enemies that we have edited and allied with us, we can summon using the left and right mouse button. Normally we would be trapped in the game, but luckily we have the power to fill in this piece of deleted content, so let's see what's behind door number one. Oh. Well, this looks new. Well, it looks old, but it definitely doesn't look anything like we've seen out of the brutalist high fantasy that's going on up above us. This looks like something more like a sci-fi game out of, I don't know, like the 90s? You know, back when low poly and low res was the name of the game. I'm gonna shut up for a minute and let you listen to the music, because it's fucking great.
This is my world. Told you I was old.
Oh, the old pro definitely wasn't lying. Feels like we're starting to get close to him, though. I'm still not really sure who or what he is.
In my day, the gods were cocky. Figured they could handle more than one hero. See that elevator door? It won't open for just you. I can help you trick it, though, maybe. Find me in Hibernetics.
It's feeling like we're starting to get really close to the old pro. I am going to take a quick detour over here to discover a new character, the corpse. Unlike us, he can't enter ghost mode when he dies. Let's breathe a little bit of life back into him, maybe. I happen to have a pair of grounded melee, so I'll stick them on him, make him an ally of mine, and we'll go to town. We're going to be starting to get more powers beyond just simple ground movement and melee attack, though. Giving a creature a power modifies their appearance of corpse, of course, and the corpse gets a pixelated sword. I'm going to try to keep our number of companions low, though. Toting around a dozen plus friends seems like fun, but it can get pretty excessive. I don't think we'll really need that many of them anyway, at least not for what I have planned. That button press is incredibly satisfying. I guess we just learned a valuable lesson about electrified doors. As a human, with life, with a body, we can't do anything about them. They kill us immediately. Luckily, as a ghost, we can walk right through and see what's behind.
10 years. We've all aged 10 years hitting beta. We're down to minor fixes. So as project director, the most valuable thing I can do now is to record, you guessed it, creator commentary. But first, scotch. Indulge me in a toast to the team. The sad tale of the space station Limina and its fateful encounter with the Circle is all of our baby. Here's to you.
Welcome to the space station Limina. A relic of an older version of the Magic Circle, whose geometry conveniently manages to intersect perfectly with the black and white fantasy world up above us. This younger Ish from this audio log appears to be a lot more humble than his irritable current self. He's already spent 10 years just trying to build this follow-up to the Magic Circle text adventure, the thing that put him on the map. Everything around us appears to be the culmination of a lot of hard work. Of course, it doesn't resemble at all the world up above. It makes you wonder what's happened in the time of that voice recording to now. It's been over a dozen years, and it appears that he's almost entirely scrapped this sci-fi world in favor of something a little more traditional.
If the gods ever finished my story, I was supposed to wake up here. But the hibernation pod is sealed. I can't open it from inside. Think you can spring me? Going on 20 years I've been stuck in here, waiting for the gods. When I got bored, I reached out into the system to learn the ropes and to look for someone like you. This arm implant was meant for my world, but it should help you boss your pets around. Find a way to take my arms with you. I'll come along for the ride. Can talk your ear off from inside your head. Plus, your new set of arms should help you con that scanner at the elevator. It wants a second hero, but my guess is anyone will do.
With the old Pro's arm, it looks like we have some basic control over our allies. We can set little waypoints and they'll try to follow them as best they can. We're gonna send them away, though.
If it's alive in this world, everything it does is a word of God. Fly or fall, fight or fuck, they burned that word into its head and said, go. You want to take on the sky bastard? You gotta trap their creations. Tear the powers out of them and stitch them back together your way.
It's unsurprising that the old Pro harbors a bit of a grudge towards the developers of the game, especially considering he was apparently meant to be the protagonist, and he's been stuck in stasis ever since. Luckily, we have his power, and with the ability to send waypoints and move our creatures around, we should be able to send somebody past this broken door. It's kind of a low clearance. I don't know if Mushroom can make it, so what I'm going to do is strip all of their powers out to keep them from clipping into each other, and I'm going to send in our new buddy, the Cyber Rat. I really like that when you take away the corpse's ability to walk, he lays back down, but because he's still an active creature, he can spin around and follow us. In you go.
I knew it. They were too lazy to make that scanner look for something specific. I had this world near to fixed, despite the gods. Then they scrap the whole damn thing and start over with the magic frickin' kingdom up there. Now I know. They ain't never gonna finish. It's a big loop. And you and me, we were born to break it.
I really can't say how much I love this music. It bears repeating so many times. So it appears the SS Limino was also searching for the magic circle. Here we have a new enemy, the Dorbot. Well, I guess he's a neutral character. But he has a special ability, the first special ability we've seen, called Lightning Rod. The probe on his head will allow us to disrupt the electric doors, the one that killed me previously. I'm also going to take his ability to move around by ground, because you never know when you're going to need that. On second thought, why don't we bring him with? May as well show off as many of these new characters as I can. Again, notice I gave him melee, so now he can attack. I also totally forgot to make him an ally. If I just make him a neutral creature, he won't do anything, because I didn't tell him to hate anything, I didn't tell him to love anything, so he's just going to kind of sit around. So I'm going to give the Cyber Rat the probe here, the Lightning Rod. We do actually have a map available to us. This will allow us to summon any neutral creatures. You can see I can just click on them, or any creatures that are allied to us. And it also lets us travel around, so if we get stuck somewhere, we can pop back to one of those cracks and continue on from there.
So the original text adventure only briefly touched on the distant future at the end. Back then, I just wrote whatever I wanted you to imagine, and were shocked when you paid me so well. So I may have surprised you to begin on a space station. And I recognize that compared to the original, this time, your hero was a little more anti. Anyway, for all his faults, I hope the pro found a way under your skin.
It looks like Ish really did intend for the old pro to be less of a traditional protagonist, and to have a bit of a dark streak, which he's demonstrated pretty well. Again, you can take these special abilities out and put them on just about anybody. I really think it looks cool on a character like Clyde, who belongs in the kind of high fantasy, the fact that they just literally bolting on this kind of low poly lightning rod. We're not able to get to that developer commentary, but we'll have to loop around back in a little bit. Just like that, it looks like we've reached the end of this part of the SS Lemina, but I'm sure we'll be back later. And off in the distance, we can see the original, the Magic Circle.
Coda, you are not capturing video of this. This is not the plan.
The fans deserve to see the truth. Someone brought the old sci-fi version back, and now we know. It was finished, and you both canceled it.
Ishkut multiplayer. I didn't want my name on it. Plus, Coda, that was years ago. Focus on the demo. You sold Ish on giving me a sword to satisfy action fans. Now make his avatar mortal. I kill Starfather, the crowd laughs at Ish, and at last, he fires me.
No. Maze Evelyn, you rose from the fan community, but you have forgotten us. And before we fire you, you will atone. Just check your mail.
What if... effective immediately, all likeness rights. Ish signed my brand over to you?
Never even asked why. We are your only way out now. After this is done, we have a new demo plan for you. Till then, stay in your room and think about what you've done. We still love you, we just expected more.
You brought back my world and drew the bastard in, boss. But it's using cheats. So those old whirlybirds up there will act like it's bodyguards. Now you need a plan to deal with all three. I know for sure you ain't got the parts you need yet. Could take a while. Go find them.
One, two, three.
Looks like Coda's finally turned on Maze. Luckily for us, we have a developer of the game out in the open. Unfortunately for us, she's... across a pit with two whirlybird bodyguards.
Double check those notes.
Like the old pro said, we can take her down. We just lack the necessary resources. I'm gonna leave Clyde behind for now. He'll definitely become relevant later, though. As you can see, we have a big ghosted chunk of the SS Limina. We're going to go ahead and fill that in. The teleportation bay sounds very interesting. Unfortunately, it's locked for now. There's a couple different ways we can go. We could head up to that castle. We could head over. There's actually a part of the SS Limina that we can go to. I'm just gonna go ahead and strip all of these powers from this. Jugadillo? We could try heading across to this volcano. Unfortunately. As you would expect. I'm not going to show it off, but as you would expect, the lava's going to get in our way. Looks like there's a couple rocks over there, but we can't reach those. I could use the map to pull them over, but... What's a rock going to do me? Nothing. Nothing right now. In this kind of open area, there's definitely a couple different ways you can... attack the parts of this world. I have a pretty clear strategy of how I want to go about this, though. Just to show off all of the different powers and all of the different ways that you can do it. We're going to go over here and take a look at the Sentinel. He appears to be blocking our path. Not that we can really cross across there, but he has the power to float, and that could be very useful for us. I'm going to send in our ragtag group to see if they can't take him down. Unfortunately, they can't reach, and in addition, the Sentinel has the power to push people away. Not much we can do right now. Over in this nightmare of hands, there's a couple creatures blocking our paths. Flamers. I think we stand a little bit of a better chance because we can actually get up to them and attack them. Or not. I keep trying to revive my... I keep trying to revive my allies, but... that's kind of a brute force solution, and I think there's a more elegant way to take care of that. So we'll be back.
Coda. I told you this sci-fi stuff is completely irrelevant to the demo.
It wasn't me, sir, truly. Just some kind of glitch. With great dramatic timing.
I see. Wow. How old is this stuff? My God. It's years. I'll be 61 in the fall, Coda. No family. For better or worse, this is what they'll remember me by.
Yes, exactly. On that demo stage, you have to make yourself believe again.
Long ago, I proposed a system that would generate unique offspring from player behavior. You could teach them like real children. The tech team said no.
This is your baby. Tech will have to take the fake demo version as a challenge.
You know? Yes, dammit. Saying this aloud, how can the demo be about anything else? That crowd has to see a child born into our world and love it as I do. To fear for its future as I do. What was it I said at the end of the original text adventure? By the time we understand our legacy,
it is too late to change it.
I think the last place we're gonna check out is this castle over here. Now that I've got my whole crew, I've got a terror that I can keep sucking life out of. This castle appears to be the lair of the Hiver Queen. These hivers go down pretty easy, but there is quite a few of them. So let's see if we can't get inside one of these guys. Oh. They appear to be locked out by an ability called Groupthink. They mimic the Hiver Queen, so it appears that the Hiver Queen has this ability called Groupthink, and she is... makes it unable for us to edit them in any way. I could bring them back to life, but they would just keep attacking me. So for now, I'm just gonna let my crew clean out these hivers. Oh god, they're all dead. Luckily, they don't hit very hard. I can trap them, but again, I can't really do anything about them. Gonna have to kill them. Watch this, though. I can actually lure this other hiver into this trap. Clyde, it's time to be useful. Time to grow some legs. Time to grow some teeth. Go fight. Serve me. I knew you had it in you. Clyde, you've been good to me so far. I've got big plans for you, Clyde. Oh, yes. Let's bring back the rest of the crew. Bring them back to life. And decide where we want to go from here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next episode.